नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो शिष्यभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितः प्रज्ञानघनः प्रत्यगर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथासि शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथासि पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरुं सन्ततवानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचर विचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरीसहोदरापमहत्पदम् तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् सो वी वेर लुकिंग एट दी एनालिसिस लीडिंग टू दी अध्यास भाष्य बिगिनिंग विथ युष्मदस्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरयोः इत्यादि. So towards that goal, the connections are to be known as to who is the adhikari, what is the sambandha, etc., between the vishaya and the prayojana and others. That has been established for the Shruti also and for the initial sutra, Athato Brahma Jignyasa. However, there is a question regarding this as to पूर्ववाद्यनुमानस्य सत्प्रतिपक्षानुमानं रचयति. पूर्ववादी मीनिंग पूर्वपक्षी हैड ऑब्जेक्टेड दैट दिस विषय इज नॉट पॉसिबल, दिस ऐक्य विषय. सो इफ यू लुक एट व्हाट हिज ऑब्जेक्शन वाज, इट वाज अत्र इन द व्याख्या ऑन पेज 11, अत्र नाहं ब्रह्मेति भेदग्राही प्रत्यक्षेण कर्तृत्वाकर्तृत्वादि कर्तृत्व अकर्तृत्वादि विरुद्ध धर्मवत्व लिंगकानुमानेन च विरोधेन ब्रह्मात्मनोर ऐक्यस्य विषयस्य असंभव. द विषय विच इज ऐक्य बिटवीन जीव एंड ब्रह्म इज नॉट पॉसिबल, देर इज अ विरोध, बिकॉज ऐक्य एंड कर्तृत्व कैनॉट गो टुगेदर. ऐक्य कैनॉट बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड व्हेन कर्तृत्व एंड अकर्तृत्व हैव विरोध. Brahma is akarta, whereas jiva is karta. And similarly, there are other viruddha dharmas in Brahma as opposed to the jiva dharmas. Thereby, this was the anumana. Of course, pratyaksha, naham brahmeti bheda grahi pratyakshina. So, pratyaksha and anumana was shown. So, naham brahma is pratyaksha siddha. And Anumana tells you that Viruddha Dharmas cannot go together. And it was mentioned that there is Satpratipaksha Dosha in the Hetu that is used by the Purvapakshi in the Anumana. Pratyaksha anyway, the issue is a non-issue really. The pointed out issue by the Purvapakshi is a non-issue because we never say that Vishishta has aikya with Brahma. The aikya is not between Vishishta. Vishishtas, it is not between jiva as is, a samsari jiva, and the asamsari Ishvara. There is no aikya possible. We never said it. So, apraptasya nishedha na kartavya. We need not talk about it. It is aprapta. But even if you have to look at it, let's say pratyaksha aham brahma is not there, but aham na brahma, this is pratyaksha, and this is to the masses. So there, bheda is definitely there, and for bheda you don't need for bheda the anuyogi should have yogyata, not pratiyogi. For pratyaksha, pratiyogi should have yogyata. For example, if you want to say this is Vandhyaputra, or let's say Gagana Pushpa. So we'll say this is Gagana Pushpa. Is it Gagana Pushpa or not? To know that it is not Gagana Pushpa, pratyaksha you are having of the Gagana Pushpa. If I were to say, look at this, this is Gagana Pushpa. You know it is not Gagana Pushpa. But if you want to look at it and say, is this Gagana Pushpa, for pratyaksha you need pratiyogi. Meaning, now let's say there is no Gagana Pushpa here. Obviously, there is no Gagana Pushpa to have pratyaksha. But if I want to say that Gagana Pushpa nasti atra, if I say that there is no Gagana Pushpa here, this is not bheda. The reason for this inquiry is to see bheda, whether there is virodha, there is bheda. So if pratyaksha of Gagana Pushpa is possible anywhere for anyone, if pratyaksha of Gagana Pushpa is possible, then that will become pratiyogi to abhava of that Gagana Pushpa. Yasya abhava sa pratiyogi. So if I want to talk about abhava of the Gagana Pushpa, then Gagana Pushpa should exist. Gagana Pushpa isn't there. Therefore, pratyakshatvam is not possible. However, for bheda, that expectancy isn't there. So if I show you something and say this is not Gagana Pushpa, that is not similar to abhava of Gagana Pushpa. It is anyonya abhava. It is abhava, all right. Nayayika will say that this bheda is anyonya abhava. Ghataha patona. For that, you do not need pratiyogi. You need only anuyogi. Anuyogi should have yogyata. Pratiyogi Gagana Pushpa does not have yogyata of pratyakshatvam. But for bheda pratyakshatvam, of what? Not of Gagana Pushpa abhava, atyanta abhava. For Gagana Pushpa bheda from anything else, I show you a ghata, pata, or whatever, I show you a simple pushpa, let's say. I show you a Sarit Pushpa and say that this is not Gagana Pushpa, then the understanding takes place. Jnanam udeti eva. Why? Because bheda is pratyaksha there. And for bheda, anuyogi should have yogyata. Thereby, when you say that there is bheda which is pratyaksha, naham brahma, ghataha patona, naham brahma, there what is having yogyata here? Is that graha possible? Grahana possible? It is possible, it is there for everyone. There the aikya is not pratyaksha. Brahma, aham brahma, the way you want to have anubhava of as a vishaya, that is not possible. Brahma does not have that kind of yogyata. Brahma is not pratiyogi for pratyaksha vishaya, becoming pratyaksha vishaya. So when you say naham brahma, there that yogyata is not needed. What is needed? What you are objectifying is actually sharira. So vishishta brahma and vishishta jiva have bheda. We have not claimed and we are not going to claim that there is aikya between this vishishta jiva and vishishta brahma. There is no possibility and we have not claimed it. So bheda is pratyaksha, let it be. There is no virodha of that bheda which is pratyaksha with the abheda that we are claiming based on Shruti between Aham and Brahma, which are Avishishta Jiva and Avishishta Brahma, Shuddha Chaitanya Ityartha. Tayoh Virodha Nasti. There is no Virodha between them. So Pratyaksha Virodha is not an issue at all between Vishishta. That does not change anything about the Aikya, which is the subject matter of the Shruti, which is the Vishaya of the Shruti. So there is no opposition at all. As for Anumana, there is Sat Pratipaksha Dosha, meaning there is a Pratipaksha Hetu, opposing Hetu, to the Hetu given by the Purvapakshi to counter Aikya in the Anumana. Now when there is a Sat Pratipaksha Hetva Bhasa, then whichever is stronger, generally they are considered as equal. Provided there is something which is going to prove one as superior to the other, one having more weightage than the other, Sat Pratipaksha will stand so, as in it's a Dushta Hetu. Which is right cannot be concluded unless there is something which weighs heavier than the other. One among the two should weigh heavier. Otherwise, it is just a counter to the Hetva Bhasa, as to this Hetva Bhasa. So it's a Dushta Hetu. It is not a right Anumana. So you cannot conclude as to Bheda being real. And thereby the Purvapakshi cannot prove that Aikya cannot be a Vishaya between Jiva and Brahma. So this much is the background to the Satpratipaksha, which is Dosha which exists in the Purvapakshi's Anumana. So what is said here? Okay, we are back to this. So this is where we had marked it. So Purvavadya Anumanasya Satpratipaksha Anumanam Rachayati. In the Ratna Prabha, what is done is that the Ratna Prabhakara shows what this Satpratipaksha Anumana of Purvapakshi is. What is that? Hetva Bhasa Jiva iti. Ratna Prabha, Jivu Brahma Bhinnaha Tajnana Nivartyadhyasashrayatvat Yaditham Tattatha Yatha Shukya Bhinna Idamamsha iti. So this is the Satpratipaksha. Purvapakshi had said what? Jivaha Brahma Bhinnaha. Why? If you have to put it in the same way, what had he said? He had said, Naham Brahma iti Bheda Grahi Pratyakshena. So that Pratyaksha will let aside. Kartrutva Kartrutva Adi Viruddha Dharma Vatva Linga Kanumani Nicho. So this is his Linga. So Naham Brahma, Aham Brahmana, this is Pratijnya. And what is Hetu? Kartrutva Akartrutva Adi Viruddha Dharma Vattvam. That is Hetu. So Kartrutva Akartrutva Adi Viruddha Dharma Vattvat Aham Brahma Na Bhavami. And thereby what is he going to say? Satya Bandha. Bandha is Satya. Aikya is not possible, therefore it is not an adhyasa. If it is not an adhyasa, it is a satyabandha, and satyabandha cannot go by jnana. Therefore, jnanat nivritti rupa phalasya asambhavat shastram na arambhaniyam. So his kartrutva akartrutva adi viruddha dharmatvam is leading to that. Now, what is the Siddhanti saying? Siddhanti says, jivaha brahma bhinnaha abhinnaha. Why so? Aikya is definitely there between Jiva and Brahma. Tajnana nivartya adhyasashrayatvat. So Vishaya is proven taking adhyasa as a fact. And why is adhyasa a fact? Because it is jnana nivartya. Shruti says that this jnana will take away the adhyasa, which is viparita jnana, to what is a fact. भेद द्वैत इज एन अध्यास इट इज अज्ञान कार्य द्वैत द्वैत प्रपंच इज सुपरइम्पोज्ड ऑन द ब्रह्म तत्व देन देयर बाय तादात्म्य संबंध इज पॉसिबल सो देयर एक्चुअली अध्यास विल क्रिएट अ सुपरफिशियल ऐक्य बिटवीन द्वैत सो विवेक इज नीडेड अर्लियर एंड देन यू लिव अवे द अध्यस्त एज मिथ्या देन वॉट इज लेफ्ट इज ऐक्य बिटवीन ब्रह्म एंड जीव Because by superimposition on both sides, there is a division created. That division is created by individuals. What is one has been as though divided and individuality has been created. And between this individual who has tadatmya sambandha with superimposed on one part and between the adhisthana at the universal level, That Chaitanya which was not divided at all, he is not divided even during the Adhyasa, there also Tadatmya Sambandha is created. So very strange. Where there is Aikya, the Aikya is divided by superimpositions. The divisions are between Adhyastha, Aumshas and then there is a Tadatmya between the Adhyastha Aumsha and the as though divided Adhisthana. On both sides, which have to be removed for Aikya to be established. So, Dvaita is created by Tadatmya. Tadatmya is identification. So, very strange that by Aikya, so to say Aikya, because Tadatmya is Aikya. So, through Aikya, Dvaita is established naturally, not between Brahma and Jiva. But between the adhyasa on Brahma and adhyasa on Jiva, whereas there are no two. So division itself is created by this adhyasa, which is actually aikya between the adhyastha and the adhisthana on both sides when there are no two sides. Two sides are created by as though dividing the adhisthana and summing them up on each side. With Tadatmya Sambandha, Aikya between the superimposed and the Adhisthana. Thereby you seem to have two. Whereas there are two only in superimpositions. The Adhisthana, there are no two. But Adhisthana seems divided because the Adhyastha has Tadatmya Sambandha there and thereby appears divided. Now what has to be done is that these superimpositions have to be taken away. How do you take away? By actually creating Vibhaga between, so for Aikya Siddhi you have to do Vibhaga first, Mithyatva Nishchaya should be done. So Adhyastha has to be separated on both sides, Mithyatva Nishchaya has to be done and then Aikya Siddhi is automatic. What remains there is not two, it is one. And for this Shruti is the only Pramana. So to sum up, the Dvaita Prapancha has come about by superimposing Dvaita and creating Aikya between them, between the Adhisthana and the superimposed. And thereby multiple Aikyas between Adhisthana and the superimposed. One superimposition, two superimposition, three and so on. Therefore, you have got Dvaita in the Adhisthana. Segmentation in the Adhisthana where it is Ekarasa, whereas it is Ekarasa. Now, what has to be done is that you have to now give validity to this superimposition for Aikya Siddhi also. Then do Drigdrishya Viveka, separate out what is Drik from the Drishya, Adhyastha Drishya, and then Aikya Siddhi is possible in the so-called multiple Adhisthanas. So this is the process. So now if you come back here, how will this Mithyatva Nishchaya, Dirgdrishya Viveka be possible when the Adhisthana Drishti is there, when the Ashraya Drishti is there, and Ashraya Jnana will show you that the Adhyastha is Mithya. Now, that being the Prakriya as led by the Shruti, based on which all the Advaita Granthas have been made, including Prakarana Granthas, What do we know? Jivo Brahma Bhinnaha. Tajnana Nivartyadhyasa Ashrayatvat. So this is the Hetu. Sadhana is Tajnana Nivartyadhyasa Ashrayatvam. And Jivaha Brahma Bhinnaha. This is the Jiva is the Paksha. Brahma Abhinnatvam is Sadhyam. Hetu is Tajnana Nivartya Adhyasa Ashrayatvam. Tat kim? That is Brahma. Brahma Jnana Nivartya Adhyasa Ashrayatvat. Brahma Jnanena Nivartyam. Nivartyatvam. Kutra Vartate Adhyasa Vartate. Tasya Adhyasasya Ashraya Kaha. Who is the Ashraya? So this Jiva is Brahma Bhinna because Jiva is Ashraya for Brahma Jnana Nivartya Dhyasa. So yatra yatra Tajnana Nivartya Dhyasa Ashrayatvam tatra tatra tadabhinnatvam. Yatha Shukti Idam Amshaha. Shuktikayaha idamamshaha. So what has been said here? Anvaya has been mentioned. Yaritham tattatha. Yaritham. Yaritham means whatever is tajnana nivartya adhyasa ashraya tattatha. Tatha meaning tadaminna. That is non-different from the adhishtana. So whatever is superimposed, what is the idea? Whatever is superimposed, what is its ashraya? That is called as tathya. So in the example of shukti, so yatha, you look at the example, tathatha, yatha shuktya bhinnaha idam amshaha iti. So yaditam tathatha, meaning shuktya bhinna idam amshaha. Idam amshaha is non-different from shukti. Why so? What is Shukti? Shukti is a shell. Rajata is silver. So when the Shukti shines, Shukti or Shuktika shines on the seashore due to sunlight, intense sunlight, then it appears as silver from a distance. Rajatam. So Rajata Brahma is there. Rajata is Adhyasta on Shukti. What exactly is it superimposed on? When you say this is Shukti, that jnana will take away the Brahma that this is Rajatam. So this idam Rajatam, that Brahma is there, idam Rajatam. Just like Aham Jivaha, that Brahma is there, Aham Jivaha. In the example, is Rajata same as Shukti? No. You have to go to two different shops. In fact, you will not find, usually unless you go to a Tirtha Sthala like Rishikesh or somewhere, you may see some, you know, decorative, decorations like shell and some silver jewelry also possible. But usually, you may have to go to different shops to purchase shell and silver. Generally, they will not be in the same shop also, let alone being same. So, idam rajatam when you say, and iyam shukti, and for, you know, grammatically I'll let it be, I'll just say idam shukti. Because in Vyakrana, shukti, when you say shukti, then idam will change to iyam, the word will change. But anyway, it is idam as the pratipadikam, we'll just take that. So, idam ausha which is there in shukti, this is a shukti. Iyam Shukti means this is a Shukti, this is a shell. And Idam Rajatam means this is silver. This is silver is Yathartha Anubhava elsewhere in the jewelry shop. And Idam Shukti on the seashore is a Pramatmaka Jnana. But that idam amsha which is there in the Shukti and idam amsha in the Rajata, they are separate in these two units of knowledge. In this case of Brahma, what has happened is that instead of cognizing idam shukti, yam shukti, but idam shukti, let's say this is shukti, one ends up by saying that vishesha is not known. There is only idam jnana, idam amsha is known, but the shukti amsha is not known. And then there is a Brahma, there is due to whatever reason. Due to whatever reason, the silver which is, has been seen elsewhere or is elsewhere even now as per some, that knowledge, Vishishta Jnana, gets intermixed with this Adhishthana Idam. And thereby one gets confused as to this is silver. Be it due to, you know, Samagri being same, meaning the some features being same, that both shine. Shell also shines in the shell, in the inner of the shell. The inner inside of the shell shines when there is bright sunlight. So too silver shines when there is bright sunlight. So there is a samya. Thereby there is confusion, let's say. And then there may be other dosha, drashtru antargata dosha, as to, you know, there is kama towards rajata ityadi. So how will this Brahma go? It goes only when the shukti jnana takes place as iyam shuktihi. That idam amsha of the shukti is known as idam amsha of the shukti. But what is the Brahma? Idam rajatam. So, yatha shuktya bhinnaha idam amshaha. When it is shown that idam amsha that you see as rajata, that is actually shukti. So, the jnana is what? The Mahavakya in that case is what? Iyam Shukti. This is a shell. Then the person who has intermixed the Idam Amsha with the Rajata will see it as belonging to the Shukti. Therefore, Idam Amsha Shuktya Bhinnaha. That Idam Amsha, which is Idam Amsha? Idam Amsha of the Rajatam. Not the Rajatam that he had seen in the shop. At that time, Idam Amsha of the Rajata was of the Rajata. It was not of the Shukti. There it was Pramatmaka Jnana. But now, on the seashore, when he is seeing this Shukti Idam Amsha as Rajata, so the Rajata's Idam Amsha is a Brahma. The Idam Amsha is not a Brahma. Rajata is Brahma. But Idam Amsha, when known to belong to the Shukti, then the Idam Amsha being was always valid. Even during the Brahma time, the Idam Amsha cognition was valid, but the Vishishta Jnana was invalid, which was Rajata Jnana. So as soon as he knows that Idam Amsha, which is valid, belongs to the Shukti, not to the Rajata, Rajata has no Satta of its own, that Satta is the Satta of the Shukti, then he knows that idam amshaha of rajata, rajata idam amshaha, rajata idam amshaha shuktya bhinnaha. This, that is the aikya siddhi. So iti vishaya siddhi hetu adhyasa ityayam vishaya prayojanavatva shastram arambhaniyam iti. So the satpratipaksha hetu is what? Here the tajnana nivarti adhyasa ashrayatva. The Idam Amsha in the example was the Ashraya. Idam Amshasya Ashrayatva. Kasya Ashraya? Idam Amsha was Ashraya for what? For the Adhyasa of the Shukti. Adhyasa of the Rajata on Shukti. So Idam Amsha of the Shukti was the Ashraya for the Adhyasa of Rajata. And it is Nivartya also, that Adhyasa went away or has capacity to go away. Nivritti Yogya it is. From what? It is Nivritti Yogya. Yogyata of Nivritti is due to what knowledge? Only Tajnana. Tajnana is the Shukti Jnana. So Shukti Jnana Nivartya Adhyasa Ashrayatvat Rajata Idamshasya Shukti Abhinnatvam. Similarly, jivaha brahmabhinna. Why? Tajnana, brahmajnana, nivartya, adhyasa. Adhyasa is what? Jiva. So, brahmajnana, nivartya, jiva rupa adhyasa ashrayatvat. Jivaha brahmabhinna. This is the vishaya siddhi. So, aikya is definitely possible. And what is the hetu for that vishaya siddhi? Hetuhu adhyasaha. Vishaya is what? Aikya. Jiva brahmano aikyam. Vishayaha. Tasya vishayasya siddhi. Anena kramena bhavati. Vishaya siddhe hetuhu kaha. Adhyasaha hetuhu. So, what is the idea? If adhyasa is the hetu to show the aikya being possible, vishaya siddhi of the shastra, then adhyasa should be discussed first. If you discuss adhyasa and establish adhyasa as possible, then that adhyasa will lead to aikya siddhi as the vishaya. And then vishaya and prayojana being there. Prayojana is what? Once aikya siddhi takes place, jivo brahma, jivo brahma, bhavitum arhati. Thereby what will happen? Prayojana is adhyastha nivritti. And what is the adhyastha? Dukkhadi, samsara. So samsarittvam will go away and thereby dukkha nivritti, atyantika dukkha nivritti and nitya sukha prapti will be prayojana. So vishaya prayojana. Ityevam vishaya prayojana vatvat. Thereby vishaya prayojana being there for the shastra, shastram arambhaniyam iti. Atra purvapakshe we'll come back to this. Tika. Vishishte brahmabhedasya asambhavat antakkarana atirikto jiva paksha ityartha. So who is this jiva which is paksha, mentioned as paksha here, where there is doubt pending as to brahma bhinnava, brahma bhinnava. That is the samshaya there. So vishishte brahma abhedasya, brahma abhedasya vishishte jive. The vishishta jiva cannot be same as brahma. Nobody claims it. No Advaita Shastra claims it. Therefore, vishishta brahma bhedasya asambhavat. We agree it is impossible. This alpajna jiva is not sarvajna ishara. The alpajna jivatva vishishta brahma is not the sarvajnyatva vishishta brahma. Brahma being chaitanya. So, alpatva vishishta alpa, everything alpa, alpatva vishishta, alpajnyatva vishishta, let's say, alpa shaktimatva vishishta, let's say. So any alpatva vishishta chaitanya is not sarvajnyatva ityadi, sarvajnyatva, sarvashaktimatva, that kind of sarvatva vishishta chaitanya, there is no aikya between them. Aikya is by discarding the alpajnyatvam and sarvajnyatvam, alpa shaktimatvam and sarvajnyatvam. Shaktimattvam on both sides, then what remains is one. So vishishte brahmabhedasya asambhavat antakkarana atirikto jivaha. Where is this vishesha created from? What is the vishishta? Visheshana is what? It is antakkarana. All these are antakkarana dharmas. Alpajnyatvam is in antakkarana. It is not in atma. Atma has no guna. Atma is nirguna. Not like Nayayika say Atma has these gunas. Atma does not have any guna. It is Shruti Viruddha to say Atma has guna. So Chaitanya Rupa Atma, Satchidananda Atma, Satchidananda Brahma has no gunas. So Vishesha is due to what? Visheshanas are belonging to Antakkarana even in the Pratiti Avastha. Thereby Antakkarana Atirikto Jivaha Paksha Ityartha. So this jiva who is brahmabhinna, jiva is paksha, but that paksha where the doubt is in the shuddha chaitanya rupa jiva. Antakrana atirikta, antakrana is no longer a visheshana to this jiva. That is the jiva brahmaivana aparaha. Prabala shruti moolakatvad idam anumanam prabalam iti bhavaha. And this sat pratipaksha hetu, are you just countering it or replacing it and saying that your hetu is valid and therefore your anumana is valid? Iti chet, yes, we are claiming that our anumana is superior and has more strength. Why? Because it is not swakapola kalpita, it is all shruti siddha. Thereby prabala shruti bala. Prabala shruti mulakatva. Since the basis for this tarka, it is not shushka tarka, it has basis in shruti, therefore shruti is prabala. Nayayika cannot say, being an astika, he cannot say that okay, it traces back to shruti, let it be, but my anumana will stand stronger. He cannot say that, because otherwise he will become a nastika. Therefore, prabala shruti mulakatva idam anumanam prabalam iti bhava. Nayayika is just a upalakshana. Every dvaitin, no dvaitin should say that, let shruti say, I don't agree. So, prabala shruti mulakatvat idam anumanam prabalam iti bhavaha. Adhyasa ashrayatvat adhyasa adhishthanatvat ityartha. What is this adhyasa ashraya? Does Brahma go and offer support to everyone? No. It is naisargika, it is adhishthana, on which there is a superimposition done due to avidya. This avidya is Brahmagata va Jivagata. However you take it, avidya is there. Or maya is there. Due to that, there is superimposition. Where it belongs is a different discussion. But is it adhyastha? Both Bhamatikara as well as Vivarnakara will say yes, adhyasa is there, adhyastha. So both agree with the adhyasa bhashya. Both agree with aikya. Thereby, when countering the dvaitin, we are all together. Adhyasa ashrayatvam kim? Adhishthanatvam. Adhyasa adhishthanatvam eva. It is an adhishthana. This, what does it mean? The satta in the adhyastha is the satta of the adhishthana. Therefore, adhishthanatvam. There is no active support given by the adhishthana. Therefore, adhishthanatvam eva ashrayatvam iti uchyate. Shuddhasya atmanah adhyasa ashrayatva bhave api. Since this ashraya you cannot say. Ashraya when you say, you can say, but it can be misunderstood. What is ashraya? So people object, you know, when you say it is a support. How can its nirguna brahma become a support? How can? Because kartrutva is also adhyastha by them. Those who object also, they think that, oh, I am talking about the support as a karta. Because when you say, you know, support, nobody, when somebody offers support, it is an offering. You don't take support. When you take support also, it should have yogyata. But shuddha atma does not have yogyata of becoming an ashraya for something, literally. Therefore, what is that ashrayatvam? Shuddhasya atmana adhyasa ashrayatva bhavi api. Even if that adhyasa ashrayatvam is not possible for shuddha atma, therefore adhishthanatvam has to be understood. Tad adhishthanatvam apratihatam iti bhavaha. There cannot be any counter to saying that adhishthanatvam is there, because for superimposition, you cannot say that there is no water on the desert. You can say that, oh, ashraya, the desert is not the ground for water. You can say that. So that can be an objection. But you cannot say that for projection, for mirage water, desert cannot be the adhishtana. You cannot say, because desert is the only adhishtana. Nothing which is mithya can become an adhishtana for another mithya. So mithya adhishtana has to be sadvastu. And that sadvastu in the example of mirage water is desert. However dry it is, not even a drop of water touches that, but still it is an adhishthana for the mirage water adhyasa. Similarly here, you can say that there is no guna in Brahma, so ashrayatva guna cannot be there, but adhishthanatva is possible. In fact, adhishthanatva is possible only for Brahma, not for anything else, because sarvasya anyasya mithyatvat. Now, moving on to the first sentence of the Adhyasa Bhashya itself. टू लैंड देयर द बैकग्राउंड इज सत्यज्ञान सुखात्मा केनायम शोकसागरे मग्नः इत्यालोच्य यतीन्द्रः प्रागध्यासं प्रदर्शयामास. सो व्हाई डिड भगवान भाष्यकार टॉक अबाउट अध्यास? वी ऑलरेडी सीन इट इन दी रत्नप्रभा. हेतु अध्यास कस्य हेतु? विषय सिद्धे. कस्याः हेतु? विषय सिद्धे हेतु अध्यास. कः विषय? को नाम विषय? ऐक्यम विषय. जीव ब्रह्म ऐक्यम विषय. सो फॉर दैट विषय सिद्धि हेतु इज अध्यास. देयरफॉर प्राक अध्यासं प्रदर्शयामास. देयरफॉर भगवान भाष्यकार शोड अध्यास एट द बिगिनिंग इटसेल्फ. बिगिनिंग ऑफ ब्रह्मसूत्र इटसेल्फ ही शोज अध्यास. दैट इज व्हाई अध्यास भाष्य. अदरवाइज अध्यास भाष्य इज नॉट नीडेड. Why not start with atha word itself? Atha to brahma jidnyasa. Have some upodghata and then start off. Why talk about adhyasa so elaborately? And who is this Bhagavan Bhashyakara? Yatindraha. He is the best among yatis, sannyasis. Iti alochya, kim alochya? Why did he show this adhyasa at the beginning itself? In the Ratna Prabha we have seen Vishaya Siddhi Hetu. But Vishaya Siddhi Hetu being Adhyasa, Vishaya is established and thereby Prayojana is established. Vishaya is important only for Prayojana Siddhi. What is this Prayojana Siddhi? Dukkha Nivrutti, which every samsari finds oneself to be wanting. So Satya Jnana Sukhatma, this Nitya Sukha, how can I get? Satya Jnana Sukhatma Brahma, Aham Atma Brahma. Which kind of Brahma? Satya Jnana Ananda Rupa. So Satchid Ananda Rupa, Satya Jnana Sukha Atma, that kind of Atma I am. But still, this is what Shastra says. Kena Karanena Ayam Atma. Ayam Atma is Aham Atma. Really, kena karana shokasagare magnaha, magno asmi, really, ayam is actually something else, but then ayam is also used for, ayam is idam. In fact, there is another thing hidden here which will come up again. See, idam has been shown, ayam. Sometimes idam, this ayam, can be used for oneself also. Especially in plural, you know, in English also we say this person, these two people, all of these, that is pointing out others, Prathama Purusha, third person. But then sometimes when someone asks you, who are these, who are you? So these people, we are all these. So we are all these. There, the third person, Prathama Purusha, has been converted to Uttama Purusha, first person. So idam can be misunderstood as aham also. It can be rightly understood as aham also, misunderstood as per the Yushmat Asmat Pratyaya. So that discussion would come up. Yushmat means you, Asmat means I. But why Yushmat Asmat has been talked about and not idam and asmat? Idam is the vyavahara there. Idam should be the vyavahara. You point out something as idam, not as you. You don't talk about this prapancha as you, the prapancha. Unless you are creating a, you know, poetry or something, and in that some kind of an alankara, you say that, you know, you talk, you have a sambodhana and then you talk to the jagat. But the achetana jagat, which is talked about as yushmat in the yushmat asmat pratyay gocharayo. We'll come to that, but then this is a background which I see here. Ayam has been, ayam shokasagare magnaha. So ayam is aham here, which can be confused in the yushmat asmat also, had it been said as the idam and asmat. Therefore, Bhagavan Bhashyakara, to show atyanta virodha, he uses yushmat. Nobody confuses you and I. Nobody says you are am. But idam, these people we are, this kind of a construct is possible. Thereby, this Yushmat has been used. And that can be seen here. This is something that I read here in Ayam here. Ken Ayam Shokasagare Magnaha. But Atma is Aham. Atma is not Ayam Atma. Ayam Atma Brahma is Aham Atma Brahma really. Even when Shruti says Ayam Atma, I understand it as Aham Atma. Because Atma is Aham. It is Pratyagatma for each and everyone. Atma cannot be, you know, your Atma, his Atma, her Atma. It is Mama Atma with Raho Shiravat Shashti, which is what Aham Atma. Therefore, I am and Atma being in Samanadi Karanam, this I am and I who am Satyajnana Sukatma, Kena Karanena Shokasagare Magnosmi. Why am I immersed in being Sukarupa? So, Satyajnana, let Satyajnana aside, just consider Sukha. Sukharupa aham shokasagare kena karana magno asmi. That anandarupa sukharupa, due to what reason am I in immersed, completely immersed in this shokasagara, dukkhasagara, samsara sagara, which is dukkharupa. Iti alochya, thinking this Bhagavan Bhashyakara Yatindraha prak, in the beginning itself, prak meaning we can say Kasmat Prak, if you ask, then we have to say Kasmat Prak iti chet. Sutra Bhashyat Prak. Before the first Sutra Bhashya, he takes up Adhyasa. Adhyasam Pradarshayamasa. Now, what is the Hetu here which has been given? Tajnana Nivarti Adhyasa Ashrayatvam. That is analyzed in the Tika. Ittham. This Yaritham Tattata. What is Ittham? Ittham means Yadajnana Nivartya Adhyasashraya Ityartha. So, yatra yatra yadajnana nivartya adhyasashraya tvam tatra tatra. Tatha is what? Tatra tatra tadabhinnam ityartha. Tatra tatra tadabhinnatvam. So, yatra yatra yadajnana nivartya adhyasashraya tvam tatra tatra tadabhinnatvam. So, here it is again tajnana. Tajnana to put together with yaditham tattata, we can convert that to yat. So, yatra yatra yajnana nivarti adhyasashrayatvam tatra tatra tadabhinnatvam. Tat and yat being relative and correlative, they mean the same entity. Samanadhikaranam is there. So, in the example, idam amsha shruti jnana, this is a typo. So, I get more confidence to correct this because yesterday or day before, I didn't have much confidence to. Of course, the confidence is still less because I should not go out and strike out and replace something which has been there in the books and created by, you know, Mahajnanis. But then I have some, you know, I see that this can be a typo. So it is not, it's a typo. It's a Tankana Dosha. Looks like. Why? Because Shruti is a word which is out of place here. Idam amsha shruti jnana nivarti adhyasashrayatva shuktya bhinna iti visheshe. So there is shukti. This should be shukti. So idam amsha. So we will read it that way. It makes sense. In the exemplified, it can be extended to aikya jnana shruti or something like that. But then idam amsha shukti jnana nivarti adhyasashrayatva shuktya bhinna iti visheshe samanya vyapte parivasanam ah yathaiti. So with the example, he says that idam amsha, which idam amsha? Rajata gata idam amsha. Idam rajatam iti vakya gata idam amsha. So idam amsha shukti jnana nivartya adhyasa ashrayatva. It is an adhyasa ashray, we saw in the Moola itself, Ratna Prabha. This idam amsha is what? Shuktya bhinnaha. Idam amsha of the Rajata is same as the Shukti itself, not the Rajata. Because Rajata Adhyasa, Rajata is an Adhyasa whose Ashraya is that Idam amsha itself, Shukti itself. So Shukti Jnana Nivarti Adhyasa Ashrayatva Shuktya Bhinnaha. It is idam amsha is non-different from shukti because shukti jnana takes away this adhyasa of rajata अनिदम अंश इति विशेषे समान सामान्य व्याप्ते पर्यवसानम आह. सो दिस विशेष एग्जांपल लेट्स यू कंक्लूड एज टू व्हाट इज सामान्य व्याप्ति यज्ञान निवर्ति अध्यास आश्रयत्वाद. सो यत्र यत्र यज्ञान निवर्ति अध्यास आश्रयत्वम तत्र तत्र तदभिन्नत्वम. दिस इज सामान्य व्याप्ति. सो व्हाट इज दी पर्यवसान ऑफ दैट व्याप्ति. इन द एग्जांपल यू कैन लुक एट इट एंड डू अ समन्वय. हेतु हेतु प्रविष्टत्वेने हेतु इत्यर्थः. सो व्हाट इज हेतु अध्यास. सी हेतु इज व्हाट इन द रत्नप्रभा विषय सिद्धि हेतु अध्यास. व्हाट इज दैट हेतु. हेतु इज हेतु प्रविष्टत्वेन हेतु. इट इज अ हेतु बिकॉज इट इज पार्ट ऑफ दैट हेतु इटसेल्फ एंड दैट इज द हेतु फॉर द हेतु. उपायेति रत्नप्रभा तत्र पूर्वपक्षे बंधस्य सत्यत्वेन ज्ञानाद् निवृत्तेः उपायांतर साध्या मुक्तिरिति फलम्. नाउ द फल भेद आल्सो हैज टू बी देयर इन द बिकॉज इट इज एन उपोद्घात ऑफ द अधिकरण. दिस अधिकरण संगति ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स फल भेद. फल भेद बिटवीन द पूर्व पक्षी पर्सपेक्टिव एंड द सिद्धांतिस पर्सपेक्टिव. सो व्हाट इज द फल भेद इन द पूर्व पक्ष. अत्र पूर्व पक्षे बंधस्य सत्यत्वेन. बंध हैज बीन मेंशन्ड एज सत्य एंड सत्य ज्ञान कैनॉट गो बाय ज्ञान. ज्ञानात् निवृत्ति असंभवात्. पूर्व पक्षे बंधस्य सत्यत्वेन ज्ञानाद् अनिवृत्तेः उपायांतर साध्या मुक्तिरिति फलम्. दि मुक्ति इज बाय डिफरेंट मीन्स देन ज्ञान बिकॉज ज्ञान कैन टेक अवे ओनली अध्यस्त बट नॉट अध्यस्त बंध मिथ्या बंध बट इट कैनॉट टेक अवे सत्य बंध. बट इन द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द पूर्व पक्षी द बंध इज सत्य देयरफॉर इट वोंट गो बाय ज्ञान. देन सम अदर उपाय शुड बी गिवन. सम अदर मीन्स फॉर मोक्ष. सो व्हाट इज दैट. टीकाकार सेज केवल कर्मणो वा ज्ञान कर्म समुच्चयाद् वा षोडश पदार्थ ज्ञानाद् वा साध्या मुक्तिरिति भावः. सो वैशेषिक न्याय वैशेषिक विल टॉक अबाउट पदार्थ ज्ञानाद् मुक्तिः. दि एकदेशी वेदांती विल टॉक अबाउट ज्ञान कर्म समुच्चयाद् मुक्तिः. कर्म एंड ज्ञान शुड बी डन टुगेदर. वैशेषिक विल टॉक अबाउट और अदर्स विल टॉक अबाउट दिस. नैयायिका वैशेषिक दे विल टॉक अबाउट और सांख्यास एटसेट्रा दे विल टॉक अबाउट सम पदार्थ ज्ञान. एंड देन यू सेपरेट आत्मा फ्रॉम अनात्म पदार्थ. सो 16 पदार्थस हूएवर इट इज वी डोंट केयर. ज्ञान कर्म समुच्चयाद् वा अगेन वी डोंट केयर. समुच्चयवादी बट देन समुच्चयवादी कम्स अप अगेन एंड अगेन हु कैनॉट गिव अप हिज कर्म बट स्टिल वॉन्ट्स टू बी इन ज्ञान मार्ग. स ज्ञान कर्म समुच्चय एकदेशी वेदांती. केवल कर्मण दिस इज पूर्व मीमांसक. वी केयर बिकॉज वी आर उत्तर मीमांसक. वी केयर लिटिल एज केवल कर्म. इवन इफ वी डोंट डू वैदिक कर्म लौकिक कर्म इज ऑल फॉर आनंद. एवरी पर्सन इज डूइंग इट. एवरी प्राणी इज डूइंग एवरी कर्म फॉर आनंद. आनंद इज मोक्ष स्वरूप. Even if someone says, I don't want moksha, that person is looking for moksha alone because of hunting for ananda. Every seeking is for ananda and a person says, I don't want moksha. Oh, this is exactly what you want. This is what you don't know it is called moksha. But what you want is, if you ask, what do I want? He or she will say, I want sukha. When do you want it? I want it now. How much do you want it? As much as possible. How long do you want it? Forever. So every prani wants sukha, ananda, wants it immediately, wants it never to go. So nitya sukha, dukkha nivritti, all these are ideas which are there in each and every pursuit of every prani, knowingly or unknowingly. Therefore kevala karma or jnana karma samuchya also, who it is saying we are not interested, but do we do this? That is our interest. Am I looking for ananda through karma? Am I looking for any karma, be it vaidika karma or laukika karma? Vaidika karma, we don't even know what it is. Therefore saying that, oh, I don't follow all these, you know, rules. I am a free bird. But then looking for ananda, which is not going to be possible. We have done it forever and ever and ever till now. So jnana karma samuchaya and kevala karma leading to mukti, or padartha jnana leading to mukti, is what is called as anya upaya, upayantaram. Upayantara sadhya mukti riti phalam for a purva pakshi. So sadhya mukti riti bhava purvoktam upasamharan bhashyam avatarati. Lands on the bhashya by concluding what has been said so far in Ratna Prabha, etariti. So etariti, I am not able to find that word, so looks like there is a part of Veda, so you can land on iti. Siddhante, in the case of Siddhanta, what is the Veda in phala? Siddhante jnanadeva muktiriti vivekaha. The means is, mukti is possible only from jnana. So means, vishaya is different. Siddhante jnanadeva muktiriti viveka iti sarvam manasi nidhaya. Bhagavan bhashyakaraha iti sarvam manasi nidhaya. Whatever Ratna Prabhakara has said so far is not sakapola kalpita. There are many who will tell you, this, you know, vyakhyas, tikas are not to be studied. Only bhashya, stick to shuddha bhashya. Everything is shuddha bhashya. Every tika is following the bhashya. Some matabheda, in the sense, for their audience, they may create some differences and explain it in a different way. Aikya is not compromised, and they are reading the Bhagavan Bhashyakara's mind, because there is so much of depth in the bhashya. You will see more now. In Vyakrana also there is analysis. In Mimamsa there is so much. So there is so much hidden. Purvapakshi is also reading so much. Let alone Siddhantis. So Siddhantis have to show you the depth based on whoever has doubts pending. So iti sarvam manasi nidhaya. Whatever Ratna Prabhakara has said, whatever Purnanandiyakara has said, all that is there in the mind of Bhagavan Bhashyakara. He is not going to speed you, spoon feed you everything. That is the job of the Vyakhyanakaras. Thereby, Brahma Sutrani Vyakhyatu Kamo Bhagavan Bhashyakara Sutrena Vichara Kartavyata Rupa Shrautartha Anyatha Anupapatya Artha Sutrita Vishay Prayojanavattvam Upodhatatva Tat Siddhihe Tvadhyasa Kshepa Samadhana Bhashyabhyam Prathamam Varnayati Yushmadasmat Pratye Gocharyoriti. So keeping all of this background in the mind, what is that background? Aikya is from the Shruti. Athato Brahma Jidnyasa Sutra has ekavakyata with Shrotavya Mantra. That Shrotavya Mantra has Bhutarthavada Vakyas in the vicinity, which are Tattvamasi Ityadi. They are a fact. They are revealing the truth. And these are the only source for truth. And just like there is Vishaya Prayojana Ityadi Anubandha Chatushtayam for the Shrotavya Mantra Ityadi, similarly there is Anubandha Chatushtayam for the Athato Brahma Jidnyasa Ityadi. That Tatparya Vishaya, Mahatatparya Vishaya in the Shruti and the, which will be established since there are doubts, Astivanava, in the case of the Phala also, Vishaya Ityadi also, Adhikari also, Sambandha also, therefore, Anubandha Chatushtaya has these doubts pending. Therefore, Nyayena Nirnetum Idam Sutram. This Sutra Athato Brahma Jidnyasa is for that purpose. And Aikya Siddhi, Jnana Deva Kaivalyam, Jnana Deva Tu Kaivalyam, that is possible only when the Bandha is Adhyastha. Dvaita is Adhyastha. Therefore, Anyatha Upatya, Shrautartha, Shrautartha is what? Aikya. Really, it is Aikya. And Shrautartha in the, that is a Mahatatparya. The immediate is Anubandha Chatushtaya. Anubandha Chatushtaya Siddhi is the Shrautartha there. Athato Brahma Jidnyasa Kartavya Shrotavya Vidhi is said as Vidhi, is stated as a Vidhi for Aikya Siddhi, Vichara Kartavya, Phalibhutam Jnanaya, Brahmana Phalibhutam Jnanaya, Vichara Kartavya, all this from the Ajal Lakshana and Jal Lakshana. on prakriti and pratyaya. Thereby, atha, after sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, ataha, since there is anubandha chatushtaya, there are adhikaris, vishaya is there, prayojana is possible, there is a sambandha between all these. Therefore, ataha, brahmajnanaya, phalibhutajnanaya, vicharakartavya, ichchasiddhavicharaha, pratyayagata, sanpratyayagata, ichchartha, सिद्धा विषयः विचारा विचारा कर्तव्यः. सो दिस मच ऑल दिस मनसि निधाय ब्रह्म सूत्राणि व्याख्यातु कामः. भगवान भाष्यकार इज व्याख्यातु काम, ही इज डिजायरस ऑफ कमेंटिंग ऑन ब्रह्म सूत्रास. देयर फॉर व्हाट निधाय सूत्रेण विचार कर्तव्यता रूप, विचार शुड बी डन. What is the basic vritti we have seen? Athato brahma jijnyasa kartavya. And kartavyattvam is on in vichara, because in jnana as well as in ichcha there cannot be a vidhi. Therefore, vichara kartavyata rupa shrotartha. That is the shrutyartha. That is the shrotartha. Shrotartha is sutrartha. Shrota is sutra gathartha. Shrotartha is what is the meaning of the sutra. Athato brahma jijnyasa sutra. अन्यथा अनुपपत्य, अदरवाइज नॉट बीइंग पॉसिबल. वी हैव सीन द अन्यथा अनुपपत्ति आल्सो. अर्थात सूत्रित विषय प्रयोजनवत्वम, एंड देयरफॉर व्हाट इज द इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ दैट बाय अन्यथा अनुपपत्ति. व्हाट इज द इम्प्लीकेशन? दैट इज अर्थात सूत्रित विषय प्रयोजनवत्वम. देयर इज विषय एंड प्रयोजन इंप्लाइड इन द सूत्र, implied by the sutra. Why so? Because sutra is upodghata, upodghata rupa, upodghatatvat, sutrasya upodghatatvat, tat siddhi hetvadhyasakshepa samadhana bhashyabhyam prathamam varnayati. Then why not talk about anubandha chatushtaya itself, or the implied meaning there, the sutra artha is what? Vichara kartavya, that is the real meaning. Atha means अनुबंध चतुष्टयानंतरम, साधन चतुष्टयानंतरम अधिकारी इज प्रूवन एंड देयर बाय विषय प्रयोजन इज ऑल्सो देयर, संबंध इज देयर. सो अनुबंध चतुष्टय इज देयर. देयर फॉर आफ्टर गेनिंग साधन चतुष्टय संपत्ति इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द अथ शब्द. एंड अतः मीन्स वॉट? बिकॉज देयर इज अनुबंध चतुष्टय, विषय प्रयोजन आर देयर प्राइमरीली. अधिकारी इज प्रूवन बाय अथ शब्द. संबंध इज ऑब्वियसली देयर बिकॉज देयर इज ज्ञान एंड ज्ञान प्राप्य ऐक्य, ऐक्य इज ज्ञान एंड देयर बाय प्राप्य फलीभूत ज्ञान इज दुख निवृत्ति बाय अध्यास निवृत्ति. देयर फॉर अध्यास इज द हेतु एंड देयर बाय तत्सिद्धि हेतु अध्यास, दैट अध्यास विच इज द हेतु फॉर विषय प्रयोजन, तत् इज विषय प्रयोजनत्व. विषय प्रयोजनत्व सिद्धि हेतु इज अध्यास. For this there is, you know, you can't just say there is adhyasa which is the hetu. So there is an akshepa there. And samadhana should be given. Therefore, adhyase, adhyasa visheye, yaya akshepaha, tasya tasya samadhanam is given in the bhashya. Therefore, tatsiddhi visheya prayojanatva siddhi hetu adhyasa akshepa samadhana bhashya abhyam prathamam varnayati. अध्यासम वर्णयति, विच इज द हेतु फॉर विषय प्रयोजनत्व सिद्धि. एंड इन द भाष्य देयर विल बी आक्षेप एंड समाधान. देयरफॉर बाय थ्रू द आक्षेप भाष्य एंड समाधान भाष्य, इट टेक्स अप बोथ. देयर इज अ डिवीजन इन द अध्यास भाष्य एज टू विच इज द आक्षेप विच इज द समाधान. देयर बाय वर्णयति युष्मदस्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरयति. आई जस्ट रीड दिस सेंटेंस एंड देन स्टॉप. वील सी द मीनिंग इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. बट वॉट इज द भाष्य देयर? It's way down, I think. So it is spread across across pages. So what I'll just do is that I'll just read this sentence. It's not on the screen, but I'll just read this and then we'll stop. युष्मदस्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरयोर् विषय विषयिणोः स्तमः प्रकाशवत् विरुद्ध स्वभावयोर् इतरेतर भावानुपपत्तौ सिद्धायां तद्धर्माणामपि सुतराम् इतरेतर भावानुपपत्तिः. We'll see the meaning in the next part, huh? But it begins with युष्मदस्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरयोः. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजांगमनंत सुखाकृतिं. एनी क्वेश्चंस? ओके, आई विल सी यू नेक्स्ट पार्ट. नमस्ते.
धन्यवाद.